Mauritania is hosting the African Union Summit in the capital, Noua-chott. The 31st AU Leadership Summit starts on Sunday, but foreign ministers are already in the country to set the agenda for the heads of state. Corruption, migration and intra-African trade are some of the topics up for discussion. Egypt is participating in the preparatory meetings as it prepares to take over the chairmanship of the African Union in January 2019. Well, for more on this, CGTN's Robert Nagila joins us on the line from the capital city of Mauritania, that's Noua-chott. Robert, this weekend is going to be a busy one at the AU summit in Mauritania. What's likely to dominate the agenda, do you think?
Well, Karen, there are quite a number of items on the agenda for Africa's leaders when they come into town over the weekend. But perhaps the main ones, they'll touch on South Sudan, which is a really, really big deal here because of the peace deal that's been signed between President Salva Kiir and Mr. Machar, the rebel leader. Now, the hope here is that they can get both of them, they can get guarantees out of both of them to stick to that agreement and ensure that fighting does not resume again so that they can begin now to rebuild the country. They can begin to get those who fled the country to come back into the country. But the main thing they need to do is get guarantees from both leaders that they will stick to this agreement. And then, of course, you also have gender is quite big on the agenda this time around. You've got President Paul Kagame of Rwanda, who will be hosting a major conference on Saturday afternoon on women empowerment, women in power. So that's one of the highlights to look out for on Saturday. He is also scheduled to speak. And then, of course, corruption, which is the main theme of this summit this time around. The realization that corruption has been a huge dent to a lot of the economies of member states here, and something really needs to be done. As we speak at this particular moment, there are several countries around the continent that are grappling with mega corruption scandals. So this is something that they need to talk about. They need guarantees from various member states as well as to what they're going to do to curb the spread of corruption in those countries and take action and make sure that it doesn't affect the economies, because if the economies are affected, that means that the livelihoods of the people in these member states are also affected. Karen?
Hey, thank you very much for that update. That was CGTN's Robert Nagila there.